check. Yes.
Hey. I feel like I heard this sample before. I like it.
Yeah. Look, the most decorated, competition decimated. My driver's dedicated. Your driver's designated. Niggas got you to the spot. And then you said,
my drive is dedicated, right? Your drive is designated. Because he's dedicated with his drive, his motivation in life, versus you having a designated driver, aka you are not even driving the car or in charge of your destiny like Drake is. Let's go.
My drive is dedicated. Your drive is designated. Niggas got you to the spot. And then you separated. Reasons for it speculated. We know how it escalated. Rarely celebrated. Grade 11 educated. Radio was king again. Billboard got me regulated. Wanna make it fair for you. Numbers that I generated. Do right and kill everything. People knew that death awaited. Taylor Swift.
Do right and kill everything. The acronym for Drake. We had a Young M.A. shout that on that Eminem track too.
Numbers that I generated. Do right and kill everything. People knew that death awaited. Taylor Swift, the only nigga that I ever rated. Only one could make me drop the album just a little later. Rest of y'all, I treat you like you never made it. Leave your label devastated.
Rest of y'all, I treat like you never made it. I don't care when anybody else drops. I will drop on my day and I will own it. You know, some artists don't want to drop when other artists are dropping because they don't want to affect their charting numbers. The only artist that Drake keeps an eye on sideways is Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift, the all. I never thought he would say that in a track, man. That's crazy.
Album just a little later. Rest of y'all, I treat you like you never made it.
Let's
leave
go.
Your label devastated. Even when you pad the stats, period, I never hated. Even when you stab me in the back, the vest is metal plated. Trying to see a B inside my circle like I'm getting graded. Man, all this luggage and
a B inside my circle. You know when the teacher gives you a grade and then they circle it? Versus a B inside of his inner circle, like trying to get a billion. And then when he had like the period bar, I wonder if he was tying that back in with the Taylor Swift line. So
metal plated, trying to see a B inside my circle, like I'm getting graded. Man, all this luggage in the lobby, like I'm getting traded. Every time you need me for a boost, I never hesitated. Every time a Yeezy called a truce, he had my head inflated. Thinking we gon' finally piece it up and get the levitated. Realize that everything premeditated. Everyone was good with me then. Everyone expression faded. Ticking.
Wow, he's talking about the Kanye beef. And didn't Kanye reached out to Drizzy because they wanted to do that concert, didn't he? He's trying to free the, I can't think of the name. He's trying to free that dude. But anyway, so he reached out to Drake and he called a truce because, you know, longstanding beef between Kanye and Drake. But then the premeditated lines makes me think Drake was like, Kanye wasn't being genuine with that, right? Like, he feels flattered that he wanted to reach out to him and he wanted to call a truce and he actually wanted to work with him, meaning like, I actually do respect you, right? Because why would you want to work with someone if you don't respect them, if you don't have that level? Oh, that bar hits a little bit differently, man.
That everything premeditated. Everyone was good with me then. Everyone expression faded. Ticking time bomb and they begging me to detonate it. If I press this red button, dog, everybody heaven gated. Press this red button, dog, and everything forever changes. Word to M Dollar, she the only one could maybe save it. Should've hit you first, but sis, you know about the shit I take it. Niggas think it's sweet, but I am not a die.
Word to M Dollar. So we had Kanye lines, and right there he's talking about the Rihanna kind of beef as well. Should've reached out to her first, because she's Rihanna's friend, right? So, like, he should've done that instead of letting things escalate. Also, I didn't want to shout out the bar because somebody's going to say something about it, but it was a dope bar talking about having the luggage in the lobby like he's getting traded. Think about it. If you're always, like, getting traded, you can never really move into your city because you're onto a new city, a new team and all that, and he's just stacking up the luggage. I mean, Drake is just punching in, man. Punchline, 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 bars, bars, bars. You want Drake rapping? Here we go.
Should've hit you first, but since you know about the shit I take it. Niggas think it's sweet, but I am not a diabetic patient. No.
You think it's sweet around here. You're going to find out it's not so sweet around here versus being a diabetic patient, right? And you can't have lots of sweets because that messes with your blood and sugar intake.
Niggas think it's sweet, but I'm not a diabetic patient. No. I will start blacking over here like it's segregation. I will fucking double cross you niggas like it's meditation.
Again, punchline to punchline to punchline, blacking like the days of segregation when you separated white and blacks. He's going to start blacking out over here versus double crossing him like going cross-eyed, crossing him behind his back, or crossing your legs like you're about to meditate in a yoga position.
Yeah, like it's segregation. I will fucking double-cross you niggas like it's meditation. I'll give you a hard pill to swallow, this your medication. I will fucking pop up on your ass like a revelation. I could tell you better than I show you, this a demonstration. I will fucking leave you in
the... Right, he's gonna pop up on you, surprise. He's gonna pop you versus like all of a sudden you have this revelation, this brainwave idea.
Revelation. I could tell you better than I show you. This a demonstration. I will fucking leave you in the dirt like some vegetation. Chemicals is mixing in my brain and killing hesitation. I will fucking force a few shots like a vaccination. Niggas fucking call me up the cap. It's not a graduation. I will fucking put your ass on pause like I'm Pastor Mason. I will set alarms off and call.
Pause. Like Pastor Mason, aka Mace. And Cameron in the podcast, and they always go pause, right? When they have like a homosexual reference or innuendo playing off of that. Hang on, pause. What'd you just say? And then before that, like the cap to graduation, like if you're capping with him or he's going to start capping on you versus wearing a cap to graduation. I mean, he had just so many lines in this
one. In the dirt like some vegetation.
Barb.
Just mixing in my brain and killing hesitation.
Barb.
I will fucking force a few shots like a vaccination.
Barb, that one too. Like. Remember the vaccination? Everybody had to go get shots during COVID times. What happened to that, right? Force a few shots or he'll fire at you.
You can call me up the cap. It's not a graduation. I will fucking put your ass on pause like I'm Pastor Mason. I will set alarms off and cause a whole evacuation. I'll get to you 10 years from now like procrastination. I'll fucking find out wherever y'all are celebrating. Pull apart my phantom on the curb like I'm Larry David.
Ooh.
And then we'll see who's really crazy.
Curb your enthusiasm, Larry David bars? Let's go.
Yeah.
Already, like the Taylor Swift lines and then the curb your enthusiasm, things I would never thought I would hear Drake talk about, but here he is. And then he's speaking on the Kanye beef and the Rihanna beef. There's been a lot in this.
Curb like I'm Larry David. And then we'll see who's really crazy. Yeah.
Yeah. That was smooth too. I like how Drake just like found his pocket and he just sat in it the whole time. Like he was just composed, laid back on the flow, but man, did he punch in with the wordplay and punchlines.
Conductor.
Yeah, right back. I walked in.
Okay.
Noel said, I thought you quit. I said, nah, I'm quitting again because I started again. Gotta wait on that. It's like the storm before the calm. We'll get to the vacation later.
For real. Most people say the calm before the storm. I love how he flips that. This is the storm before the calm. I'm not taking a break. And that's the thing. Like, Drake does get a lot of hate. He gets a lot of criticism. I've given him some criticism too. But like, one of the things is he's always stayed around. He doesn't like disappear and go on this like big hiatus. Like he continues to work, he continues to produce, and he continues to output. He's always relevant, man.
It's like the storm before the calm. We'll get to the vacation later. For real.
Hey. Smooth brass right here. Got a little bit of a jazz soulful vibe.
Look.
Like that piano.
Look. This is the decompress before the intermission. Done a lot of post-game talking, but this one different. I told Lee to put him in the car, but don't pistol whip him. And definitely do not shoot his ass till you get permission. People got a heavy misread on my disposition. Talking loose, then hit me up after on some please, Drake, listen. Energy they bringing is inconsistent. I got two Virgil Benzes, one that I'm whipping right now. And the other one I'm keeping in mint condition. And niggas bound to slip eventually like they sent permission. Imagine us getting our validation from an ex.
Slip eventually like they sent permission, like getting a permission slip, or they're gonna slip up on them.
Niggas bound to slip eventually like they sent permission. Imagine us getting our validation from an ex-musician searching for recognition. Same story every time they had to.
Imagine us getting validation from an ex-musician. That's gotta be Joe Budden shots. Drake made like this whole like essay post on Joe Budden for critiquing his last album, right? Joe Budden is the ex-musician turned podcaster. And Drake went in on him. Drake was like, look, you sit here and you critique people who are successful. Like, you have this idea of how to be successful with music when you never did my numbers and you never reached my level and you quit on music. You are not the status quo for critique and to give other artists.
Not validation for the ex-musician searching for recognition. Same story every time, they heckle in repetition. I'm top of the mountain, these niggas still down at base camp. They planning their expedition. Y'all the type to catch a charge, head to the deposition, and act like the rapper named after the sex position. But let me tell you about my brother though. Let me tell you about
6ix9ine shots right there. The rapper named after the sex position, the sex position being 69. You're gonna start snitching when it's your time to step up and go to the case.
My brother though, for real. Let me tell you about my brother. Man, let me tell you about my brother though. My brother a two-toter, my brother a tombstoner. Diamonds and violence made us bond, we grew closer. Brother a clip loader, my brother a sick soldier. That nigga stick it to you for
diamonds and violence bond, but also I take it as like a diamond bond forming too.
Grew closer, brother a clip loader, my brother a sick soldier. That nigga stick it to you for real, he a lint roller. My brother a aim botter, I bought him a Range Rover. My brother
pulling out the stick, he'll stick it to you versus like a lint roller on a stick.
A flamethrower, it's like you playing EDM. That nigga a chain smoker. Whoa. Niggas won't smoke with us, I promise.
Chain smoker shout out, I'm here for it.
It's like you playing EDM. That nigga a chain smoker. Niggas won't smoke with us, I promise this game over.
But also he's literally a chain smoker because he's bringing that smoke to you. Again, very smooth wordplay throughout.
Like you playing EDM, that nigga a chain smoker. Niggas won't smoke with us, I promise this game over. Get your ass twist right here, he a cane roller. And then you niggas whine to Jay Prince like some grape growers, man. What the?
Whine like some grape growers. Why? Because grapes make wine. They are whining to Jay Prince and his label and all his connections with Drake trying to squash it.
And then you niggas whine to Jay Prince like some grape growers, man. What the? Let me tell you about my brother though. Yeah, I mean enough about me. Let me tell you about my brother though. Cause I'll backhand you boys with my right hand. You niggas do your shooting on the web, you Spider-Man. My brother robbing it down you, you juniors like Iron Man. My brother make your ace disappear like
shooting on the web like Spider-Man, right? Spider-Man shooting out webs versus you only shoot online, you are faking. But what made me had to stop it was the Robert Downey Jr. Iron Man scheme right here.
Man, my brother robbing it down you right in hand. You niggas do your shooting on the web, you Spider-Man. My brother robbing it down you juniors like Iron Man.
Robbing and down you juniors like Iron Man, Robert Downey Jr. He's robbing and downing you youngins like Iron Man. Come on.
You're shooting on the web, you Spider-Man. My brother robbing it down you juniors like Iron Man. Ooh. My brother make your ace disappear like a sleight of hand. My brother carry bundles and extensions like hair stores. It's me, him, and a white team. We moving like Paramore. He into some shit that they call Eternal Affairs for. I'm so...
Me, him, and the white thing moving like Paramore because Paramore is two dudes, right? Me and him. And then her, the white thing.
We moving like Paramore. He into some shit that they...
Shout out to Haley,
all Eternal Affairs for. I'm someone he care for. I'm someone he there for. My brother put some holes in your top. You a Air Force. I should charge for interviews. They want me to share more.
I mean, come on. No, I got the Jordans on today. I don't have the Air Forces on. Obviously, the Air Forces, come on. They got the holes in the top of them. Versus putting a hole in your top.
Just to check in with the boy like the airport. This the part of the story you wasn't prepared for. Let me tell you about my brother though. My brother say I'm better than everyone. He biased as fuck. Blood is thicker than water, nigga. His iron is up. And if you keep eyeing me down, trust me, his iron is up. Your last album was Buns. You niggas Hawaiian as fuck. Niggas so down bad they make...
Hawaiian rolls, Hawaiian buns, right? Your album was shit, basically. Sweet. But then... the iron is up, blood thicker than water, because everybody's got iron in their blood. That's why you get that metallic taste, like when your mouth is bleeding. Versus he's got the iron raised, he's always strapped.
Iron is up, your last album was Buns, you niggas Hawaiian as fuck. Niggas so down bad, they making alliances up. Clicking up with haters that was thinking and signing to us. Knowing good and well that when I drop, they inspired as fuck. Secret admirers too embarrassed, they hide in the cut. Seeing tower...
You know what, like, he just has some of these lines, like, it's straightforward to understand, right? Everybody's gonna know, like, when I drop... They're inspired as fuck, right? That's a simple line, but it's just one of those lines. It just kind of hits different, just like with the swagger and just like the truth of Drake. Like, yeah, there's a lot of people that hate his success, but they know when he's dropping and they're listening to that album And then they're going and they're working in the booth. Like, it's just, it's a different type of flex, man. And he's always got just those great one-liners that he comes through with.
Over you niggas, I'm giant as fuck. Wait on whoever to say whatever, they quiet as fuck. The city don't love you like that and they frying you up. I can't wait for the day that you choose to retire your stuff. Taking off the sneakers because you tired of tying them up. That one day you wake up and tell them enough is enough. That's when you gonna find out you're not Kobe Bryant to us. Ooh. Hey, you're not Kobe Bryant to us.
Wow.
At all. And if them hoes really love you, then them hoes, they lying to us. They say they miss when you got...
Drake is taking a lot of shots. Sometimes he names names or he leaves the breadcrumbs. Other times he doesn't. I wonder who he's shooting at. This feels a little bit like Pusha T, man, because he's talking about legacy here, right?
Wedding, you drying them up. Also, don't doubt that you sent them here and they spying on us. Man, either way, nigga, beware the dog. Deep in my character flaws. Humble back in 2012. Now I give arrogant boss. I remember Bluer Street with Neeks. We sharing the cause. Now we go for...
Humble back in 2012, man. October's finest. I remember the mixtape Drake days. I mean, what people got to appreciate is this man blew himself up, right? He took off on those mixtapes. Like, he literally built his own buzz. And then he got signed.
Now I give arrogant boss. I remember Bluer Street with Neeks. We sharing the cause. Now we go for dinner and we joke about sharing the cause. Got me a ranch and an H. Fuck all the carrying costs. Boy, I'm on top of the cake. Just like some caramel sauce.
Got me a ranch and the H. Shout out to Houston, man. Fuck all the carrying cause, like cause to carry arms. Yeah, you don't gotta worry about that in the States compared to Canada, Drake.
Fuck all the carrying cause. Boy, I'm on top of the cake, just like some caramel sauce. Fuck all the settling down. These boys married and lost. I go for dinner, they wife is there. She
married and lost, caramel sauce. You hear the nice multi-syllable rhyme schemes he's bending through, and on top of the cake, he's getting cake versus drop that sauce.
Bearing the cross. God forbid I take her and they suffer a terrible loss. Yeah. But enough about me. Yeah.
Yeah, he's rapping. He's rapping. Like that beat selection too. Did Shaq do a reaction to this? I bet you he was jumping around everywhere.
Yeah. Y'all might want to skip this one. This is Harsh Truth.
What is this one now? Truth. This is Shoe Fits.
Look, to all the ladies wondering why Drake can't rap like that same old guy, it's because I don't know how anymore. I don't know how. Yeah, I've had my beliefs tested, my faith broken in half. I try to joke and I laugh, but I just don't know how anymore, love.
But I just don't know how anymore. It's almost like he knows the pocket he should be in, but he's going contrary to it. And he just like leaves these sort of dramatic pauses and emphasis points in between. He's going like super staccato and like kind of falling behind the beat a little bit, but he's sitting in his own pocket. I like the way he's approaching the attack of this flow right here.
I don't know how. Yeah. To all the super triggered women talking down on me. Relax, drink some water. Act like you somebody's daughter. Can't get a tan from your phone light. Baby, it's late June. Open the blinds, get out the shade room. Maybe you could stop getting involved in some shit when you not involved. Or maybe you go for a walk somewhere that is not a mall. What's your baby's shoe size? Could tell by the laces they tight. Or you only focus on the steps that I'm taking in life. And then you got the ones who claim a guy that's everyone's nigga. Leave for
I like that line.
I'm taking in life. And then you got the ones who claim a guy that's everyone's nigga. Leave for a month to Columbia and now everything bigger. Even your attitude is bigger, your appetite growing. Your nigga is not even a starting QB. That nigga on the field before the game, he just practicing throwing. What happened to selling real estate, where all that shit was going? All your fucking captions lately talking about happy and glowing. All of that snapping and posing. Whole time he jealous of your past. Who the fuck was your last? Asking questions about niggas and you get slapped in the face if you happen to know him. Domestic abuse, that man is not a man for you. He's a pathetic excuse. Lying through your teeth, scared of letting your skeletons loose.
But what in the Ray Rice bars is going on here?
He's a pathetic excuse. Lying through.
Except Ray Rice was a starter. Like, again, it sounds very specific, man. Like, he's talking about this girl and he's in storytelling Drake mode. And then she's with this dude and she's acting like she's at the top, but really he's on the bench, you know?
Your teeth scared of letting your skeletons loose. But you stick around, cause who's out there that's better for you? Plus. Letting your skeletons loose
there for you. He's a pathetic excuse. Lying through your teeth, scared of letting your skeletons loose. But you stick around, cause who's out there that's better for you? Plus he paid.
I thought that was more of a bar there.
Surgeon, so your ass could get a caboose. But he wants you covering it up so your dresses is loose. Plus it's the only thing they see when you get introduced. Now you on a flight to Bogota just to get it reduced. Good Lord. More weeks of recovery clinics. Front like you love every minute. You getting pushed to the brink. You sitting at double your limit. Meanwhile, that nigga out in my city fucking on bitches. If they even mention me or showing me love, then it's finished. Jealous ass niggas. Damn. Then you got the ones that travel across the globe.
If they even showing me love, then it's finished, right? The second that she starts playing Drake on the tape, that's it.
Damn.
Mr. Cuff Your Girl.
Then you got the ones that travel across the globe. Everything is paid. They don't need a man. Don't listen to Drake. Never been a fan. You got a million hoes. Yeah, I understand. I'm never fucking you. So take that out your plans. I'm good on all you niggas till a ring is on my hand. Then I search your name. Find you on the gram. Click the link tree and see you sucking dick on cam. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Oh, hell no. It can't be.
Oh man, Drake getting okey-doked, right? Maybe someone's trying to slide into the DMs and he sees the Instagram pics. He's like, all right, that's nice. And then, you know, you click that link tree, right? You click that link tree and it drops down. Then all of a sudden you see that OnlyFans and that's when the X goes up. That's no.
This is independent, dude. Nah. So,
I mean, hey, get your money. Get your money. I just ain't for me, you know?
The ladies wondering why Drake can't rap like that same old guy. It's cause I don't know how anymore. I don't know how. Yeah. I've had my beliefs tested, my faith broken in half. I try to joke and I laugh, but I just don't know how anymore, love.
There it is. He did this at the beginning. Like the previous hook too on Stories About My Brother, right? It just feels like Drake's a good hook writer, but there's not a lot of thought put into the hook. Like, this is more focused on the raps. And it's like we're taking, like, parts of the verse and we're just, like, converting that to the hook. Like, that's, like, a typical sort of, like, rapper's hook, isn't it? Like, we're more focused on the emceeing and the raps that are going on. And then maybe we hear something that's dope. It's like, all right, let's loop that. Like, that'll work for the hook.
Don't know how. Yeah. To all the ladies on my case with a look on their face, allow me to put these bums right back in their place. For all the niggas who act 12, the fake gangsters with a Mac 12, the ones that only hit your phone up when it's past 12, baddies not the
who act 12, act like they're 12 years old versus acting like they're 12, the police, they're acting like cops running around with fake Mac 12,
the ones that only.
But hang on, he was talking about like being on the bench and stuff and 12? Running around with a Mac, Ja Morant, maybe.
Your phone up when it's past 12.
Nah, Ja Morant, like for all his flaws, man, he's still he's not on the bench.
Daddy's not the only ones worried about striking a pose. You ordering one bottle to split between five of the bros. All your boos think it's Halloween and they went ghost. That's when you go Miami on the gram and you ran.
Boo, Halloween ghost, come on.
Boos think it's Halloween and they went ghost. That's when you go Miami on the gram and you rent boats. And now they thinking you sweet with the bread like French toast. You boys nice. Becoming detectives, but ain't in no trench coats. I would never guess that you niggas is this crazy. She took dick in Ibiza, you turn into Dick Tracy. You niggas so jaded, acting hard.
A Dick Tracy shout out right there, but Tracy is now taking dick, so she becomes Dick Tracy.
Dick in Ibiza, you turn into Dick Tracy. You niggas so jaded, acting hawk tough, but you only turn green because your necklace is gold-plated. She settled for an NBA star.
Acting hawk tough, but only turn green because your necklace is gold-plated, a.k.a. you got that fake jewelry that's like turning green, right? You ain't got that real priceless shit.
You only turn green because your necklace is gold-plated. She settled for an NBA star.
Or green like the Incredible Hulk. Why did I have to say that? I had to say that because there's going to be someone in the comment section like, yo, you missed this part. You missed this part. Let me point out the obvious. Congratulations. You get the Captain Obvious Award for today.
You only turn green because your necklace is gold-plated. She settled for an NBA star. That's through playing. Instead, she got an NBA fan. That's 2K. She looking for high ground. Hate being tied down. She
That's 2K, right? The only games he's playing now is video games.
Yeah, saying that's 2K. She looking for high ground. Hate being tied down. She loved you for the first year, but those feelings died down. She living in downtown. You live with your parents still. You don't own a steering wheel, so you can't even drive down. You downloaded to my Mercedes after some time now. The track where she ride round. You know where she going before she there. Raise eyebrows. You hacking her iCloud. You committing cyber crimes. You niggas is out of line. She's finally moving on, she's only said it 1,000 times. You sold her a dream, talking that give you the world shit. Her friends wanna get her back on that diamonds and pearls shit. I mean, it was girls there, but it wasn't a girl's trip. She met a guy. She met a guy that ain't just getting by, a better guy. She about to spread her wings, and you just gotta let her fly. You know you can't control a Gemini. That's facts. She like, shh, quiet everybody, the game started. My new boo hooping tonight, and he said he play at the garden. He said if I ain't watching, then that nigga ain't starting. She point to the guy that she talking about, and it's James Harden. Damn, dog. Lost your.
Can't compete with James Harden.
Go to the sniper, huh? 13.
To the sniper, good man. I mean, hey, shit happens.
That's for you, bro.
That dude can shoot.
Look, so... To all the ladies wondering why Drake can't rap like that same old guy, it's cause I don't know how anymore. I don't know how. Yeah, I've had my beliefs tested, my faith broken in half. I try to joke and I laugh, but I just don't know how anymore, love. I don't know how. That's real.
I like the samples again in the mix. This was a dope switch up on the third track, you know, a little bit more storytelling, chilled out vibes. But there's a lot of specific references, man. Like, even though he told the story of a girl and of her, there's definitely shots fired at whoever the he was, right? That started becoming like a stalker, tracking everything that she does, couldn't let her move on. I feel like Drake's making a lot of chess moves on this album so far.
Yeah.
This is Wick, man.
Yeah.
Spacey?
I feel like John Wick. Empty clips. Yeah. Huh. Empty clips. Yeah. Empty clips. Shell cases scatter the floor, bullets they shatter the glass. I can feel the tension in this room like a chattering class. Every day breaking records, shit is just happening fast. That shit was a quick switch. Yeah. I feel like I'm always on thin ice with a thick bitch. So many shots fired, I need me a clip switch. I'm in that fucking bag right now, I'm a lip.
I mean, he has taken a lot of shots on this album so far. Definitely need a clip switch out.
So many shots fired, I need me a clip switch. I'm in that fucking bag right now, I'm a lipstick. Sabbatical in Miami, the shit was holistic.
I'm in my bag, I'm in my pocket, a lipstick, right? He's giving you that lip service, but also like a girl reaching into the bag, pulling out the lipstick.
Man, I remember niggas was joking about some tick tick, and now that rapper broke as fuck, the boy a statistic. Empty clips, yeah, empty clips. I'm almost expressionless. John Cena wouldn't know emotions I wrestle with. Played by the fact that I was born.
John Cena? It's Sheena? Who the fuck is John Cena? John Cena, shout out right there, obviously. Wrestler, entertainer, actor now.
John Cena wouldn't know emotions I wrestle with. Played by the fact that I was born a perfectionist. Still can't even wrap my mind around the success of this. Point me to your boss, nigga, you a receptionist. Nah. I really hate the fact I make this shit sound effortless. I put so much thought into the messages, it's borderline obsessiveness. Remember who you messing with. White America say I'm becoming a threat. Black America love to remind me what my mama looked like, as if I'd ever fucking forget. I'm never enough.
Pusha T definitely trolled him for that on the story of Addie Don, didn't he? Right, because Drake's got a white mother, but Drake is always identified as black. And, you know, just feeling like you want to be a part of one community, but you feel like you never fit in and you get hate like Pusha T gave him. But then you don't fit in with the other community either. You're just like an outcast on all sides.
I mean, what my mama looked like, as if I'd ever fucking forget. I'm never enough. Much to their dismay, I'm leveling up. Yeah.
I'm never enough. Man, see, that's like, that's more of like the really vulnerable, self-reflective Drake that you get. Like, it's so interesting how he walks this line, right? Between some of these just like crazy, like just swag and flex and braggadocious type bars. But then he'll turn around and he'll hit you with just like such vulnerable, raw, like intrinsic lines of what's going on up here and in here, man.
You forget, I'm never enough. Much to their dismay, I'm leveling up. Yeah. There's too much treasure to hunt. There's too many holes in the spot. The ratio 7-1. Living for right now, cause I really think heaven's a front. Nadia died in Dubai. I waited on a spirit to come by for like 17 months. That shit didn't visit me once. Damn. She wanted a better life. She wanted.
Rest in peace, Nadia. Shared that.
Some opportunity we wasn't given a bunch. Her ex would eat away at her soul. That nigga a munch. The last message she sent to my.
Ice spicy a munch.
In a bunch. Her ex would eat away at her soul. That nigga a munch. The last message she sent to my phone's about keeping in touch. So pardon me questioning God and not believing in much. It's Wick, man. Don't listen to Wick.
So now he's signing because he lost someone close to him, right? And he's starting to think that heaven's a front. That's why he lives for the here and now and does all these celebrations of material things and everything that he's doing in the right here and in the present tense.
Pedia, capital wicked nigga. I pray it don't hit the media. They say, Drake, you getting harder. Funny is getting easier. Rappers are slick comedians and they get disobedient.
I like that juxtaposition right there. Drake, you getting harder. Funny. This game feels like it's getting easier for me.
And they don't stay in their lane. It's like niggas hit the median. Bo said he the recipe. I must be the key ingredient. Capo might wick a man down.
Boat said he the recipe, a.k.a. Lil Boat, Lil Yachty, the secret recipe that he dropped with J. Cole. That's a shout out, man.
Median. Boat said he the recipe. I must be the key ingredient. Capo might wick a man down with evil deviants. They gonna have to talk. A
lot of John Wick flips playing on Wick lines.
Ouija boys like heebie-jeebie. Like the large was too big for you. You'll need a medium. Just to send a message to somebody you love. Previous empty clips. Yeah.
Production is a vibe on this album. I think that's the thing of Drake, though, is like he's always shined. Like he doesn't need production like way over the top and all kinds of changes and things going on. Like he can just like simplify production, find like just like really dope chord structures and setups and things, man, and just like dominate with his personality and his style of delivery. Like it feels a lot of times like Drake, the best formula and recipe is less is more, man.
Yo. Yo.
This is the J. Cole track. Let's go.
Everything good, everything pure. Alright.
Ooh. More soulful samples, man.
Everything pure. Yeah, I got some evil ways. Even through the glasses, you can see the gaze. To find your way up to the top, this shit gon' be a maze. Volkswagen shit, the way I'm running Beatles plays. Yeah.
The Volkswagen Beetle versus shouting out the Beatles, man. And I love how he's coming through. See the gaze, evil ways. Nice three-syllable punchlines.
Maze. Volkswagen shit, the way I'm running Beatles plays. Yeah.
But he's doing like Beatles levels and status, man, with his numbers. It's crazy.
Be amazed. Volkswagen shit, the way I'm running Beatles plays. Yeah. And we linking like we freed the slaves. I conquered hell, I walked the villain, set my feet ablaze. My heart hardens.
We linking? Drake and J. Cole are linking up versus Abraham Lincoln, who freed the slaves with the Emancipation Proclamation.
The slaves, I conquered hell, I walked the villain, set my feet ablaze. My heart hardens every year like sneakers that Adidas made. I never did the VMAs, I'm not in.
My heart hardens, aka James Harden, like the sneakers that Adidas made because Harden's got that Adidas deal versus his heart hardening and getting colder.
My heart hardens every year like sneakers that Adidas made. I never did the VMAs. I'm not in need of praise. All praise to the born sinners, Jesus.
That's the thing about Drake, man. He's one of the, I mean, not Drake, J. Cole. He's just one of the most humble MCs, man. For being his level of talent and how much arrogance he could walk around with, he's still just like got 2 feet planted solidly on the ground.
Did the VMAs. I'm not in need of praise. All praise to the born sinners Jesus saves.
Shout out to the born sinners. Obviously, J. Cole's album, Born Sinner.
I'm not in need of praise.
all praise to the born sinners Jesus saves. My brothers running through the six like the Green Berets. Beefing with a block that's 500 feet away. Wheel of Fortune shit the way they say they need a K. Nah.
What letter you need on Need a Fortune? Give me an A, give me a K, right? AK firing off.
The way. Wheel of Fortune shit the way they say they need a K. Nah. I only need a raise. And a safe to stash these Frito-Lays. Times was hard, I watched my mama rob it.
To stash these Frito-Lays, that's a smooth, just staying with that rhyme scheme, but then dropping it, instead of saying chips, say Frito-Lays, he's stacking his chips.
A raise, and a safe to stash these Frito-Lays. Times was hard, I watched my mama robbing Paul just to get Peter paid. And now my paper fold.
Robbing Peter just to pay Paul. Robbing Paul just to get Peter paid. Playing off of that, we were so poor back then. I like that flip of the idiom.
It's hard. I watched my mama robbing Paul just to get Peter paid. And now my paper folded like when teachers don't want classmates to see a grade. Time is speeding now. I see the.
That's such a bar, man. Folding up the paper. He's got so much of it. He's folding it over. Versus like when you get that F, right? And the teacher doesn't want to embarrass you, so you might get that folded, that half-folded piece of paper. You know it's coming. It's not going to be a good one.
Raise, poking out this beard, but it's weird because I feel like I ain't even aged. Y'all seize the rays, feet firmly planted for these precious flowers I've been handed. Watch me be the vase. Man, I'm living out Carlito's way. You niggas ain't getting no bread. You in a keto phase. Wisdom coming out my mouth.
Ain't getting no bread. You in a keto phase, right? Because keto, you can't have... I think there's no bread in the keto diet, right? But they're not stacking up bread. They're not making the same money, the same level.
You niggas ain't getting no bread. You in a keto phase.
And then giving flowers, beating the vase. Come on, smooth bars from J. Cole before that. I love this back and forth. Like, let me punch in a little bit. Let me give you two bars. And then Drake's like, all right, let me give you two bars. And then they just keep playing off of each other, man.
Man, I'm living out Carlito's way. You niggas ain't getting no bread. You in a keto phase. Wisdom coming out my...
And obviously the movie Carlito's Way, shouting that out. He's living this lifestyle, man. It's very like mafioso. Reminds me of like Nas, really, and like some of his shit he's been on lately with Hit-Boy.
Way, you niggas ain't getting no bread. You in a keto phase. Wisdom coming out my mouth like some teething pain. My whip used to have to see this...
Wisdom teeth that get pulled out of your mouth versus wisdom coming out of everything he's speaking right now.
Wisdom coming out my mouth like some teething pain. My whip used to have the seat displays where Smack DVD would play. Zopa clone, baby, I can't...
Smack DVD days, come on, man. Those rap days.
My whip used to have the seat displays where Smack DVD would play. Zopa clone, baby, I can't rest without the sleeping aids. Bought this nigga jewel.
Yo, we needed to do some battle rap on the channel.
DVD would play. Zopa clone, baby, I can't rest without the sleeping aids. Bought this nigga jewels, he shits his light. Let's get it reappraised. I bet you see the price and you gon' be amazed. And Broski didn't do it. He like a piece of art. Judge, he was framed. Some feed the J's to
Broski didn't do it because he's came out and defended Tory Lanez. He was framed versus framing a piece of art. I wonder. And then obviously he was taking sleeping pills just to get his rest, and then like he bought someone's jewelry and he didn't trust it, so he had to get it weighed. He felt like it wasn't what he said it was. Those are like just some subtle shots fired right there.
And Broski didn't do it. He like a piece of art. Judge, he was framed. Some feed the J's to receive a wage. Coke got their nose bleeding like the seats where you can't see the stage. High up in arenas where they see their faves. AK.
Right? Cocaine can lead to nosebleeds versus sitting up in the nosebleeds like when you can't see the stage. That's a smooth flip right there from Cole.
Like the seats where you can't see the stage. High up in arenas where they see their faves. AKA me and Drizzy Drake. We the wave. Yeah. We the wave. Like Christian Combs with a brush in his hand once the grease is laid. Shit is three.
Christian Combs, he's got that wavy, like, you know, Sean Puffy Combs style hair, right? See the wave? They got a different type of wave versus like a wave of the fans doing the wave in the crowd. That was a triple.
Like Christian Combs with a brush in his hand once the grease is laid. Shit is 360 like the label deal you signed to get your people paid. Me, I got tickets like a meter made. And 21, my nigga, like he's selling.
I got tickets still playing off of like selling out stadiums and shows, like giving tickets versus he's got meal tickets versus giving out parking tickets.
People paid. Me, I got tickets like a meter made. And 21, my nigga, like he's celebrating legal age. Next time I get it.
21 Savage, shout out, hitting 21, celebrate
meter time. Made. And 21, my nigga, like he's celebrating legal age. Next time I get in Rosalia's face, I hope she tell her people that we need some space. Niggas think I won't get him here, but like a...
Drake's been some game. He got Riz on this.
I hope she tell her people...
Rosalie, huh?
We need some space.
Okay.
Niggas think I won't get him here, but like a Indian marriage, it could be arranged. Diss me, it just may see us on your...
lot of Indian marriages that are arranged by the families. I could get a hit on you. That'll be arranged soon.
Indian marriage, it could be arranged. This mean it just may see us on your block like the street parade.
At the top playing keep away with the crown. Our life's an open book. Come and read a page. Drake pulled a white bitch that's going both ways. She like the queen of spades. I'm starting to think they perks is fake. They weed.
Obviously, if you think about cars, like going both ways, queen of spades. So she's bi. She could go whichever way you want her to go versus like the spade points up. And then at the bottom of the card, the spade points down. J. Cole,
the white bitch that's going both ways. She like the queen of spades. I'm starting to think they perks is fake. They weed is lace for thinking it's a game. If it's a game, these streets would be Bushido's blade. Raise it to his face and he ain't need a shade.
Bushido's blade. How are we shouting out that game, man? Take me back to those days.
If it's a game, these streets would be Bushido's blade. Raise it to his face and he ain't need a shade. I stay out of beef, see niggas' DNA get rearranged. I'm with Drizzy in Atlanta. So many hitters with that nigga, they could be the Braves. Young Angel going through his...
Atlanta Braves, so many hitters, like baseball hitters versus hitters around Drake whenever he rolls through Atlanta.
In Atlanta, so many hitters with that nigga, they could be the Braves. Young Angel going through his demon phase. Hard to blame him, Lord knows his game can be depraved. Scary hours, undefeated, y'all should be afraid.
Be afraid. You know what's dope is like both of them carry that three syllable scheme, that end rhyme scheme all the way through. And then J. Cole punched in between Drake too. And this is kind of what I wanted on the first collab that they did, right? You know, Drake did the whole beat switch and the whole tonal change and the flow switch. But I just wanted to see Drake and Cole just go back and forth. Just two goats on the track. And they did it here. They gave it to us finally, man. Come on.
Y'all should be afraid.
This is when I love hip hop, man. It's just like feeds the soul type of shit. If you want to keep her, you've got to change your little ways. If you want to keep her. And again, I'm loving this mix of like soulful samples in the back of the mix throughout this album. We're gonna switch up the camera.
We good?
I hope we're good.
Yeah.
It's you broke my heart.
Yeah.
Oh, baby. Don't go. Don't go.
Look. Look, my notepad caught many bodies. Screenshots solve plenty problems. Voice knows bag plenty hotties. Can't just talk to me like anybody. Can't just talk to me like anybody.
Right, his pen and pad has caught a lot of bodies over the years, that's for sure.
Knows bag plenty hotties. Can't just talk to me like anybody. Can't just talk to me like anybody. Man, you bitches know that I'm a somebody. And little baby bad, she got a John body. Bunch of feelings I just couldn't shake.
Give me that piano. Take it to church on this one.
That I just shouldn't take. You just couldn't see the good in Drake. 4 months, not a long time. But you fought somebody, you just couldn't wait. Mm. You broke my heart. You broke my heart.
You just believe.
Yeah. Careers on shelves like Amazon.
I thought it was setting up like that. I love how like it almost went into a tunnel in terms of the mix, right? The way it was filtered. So it was like just like super, super shallow, that piano running. And then you had that sample. So it like made you like really like lean in to listen. Like, hang on, what's she singing? What's going on here? And it's just like it's not filling any space. And then all of a sudden you have the percussion kick in and everything just widens dramatically. And then Drake drops in and he was singing before and it sounds like he's about to go in and start rapping. I just love the way that that sets up musicality wise. We're like here, very shallow. We're about to widen it in a second, right?
Yeah.
Give me that bass.
I put careers on shelves like Amazon distribution center. Hell, really hate to call on Broski for the dirty work.
I put careers on shelves like Amazon distribution centers. Drake is at his prime right now. That's that next day delivery.
Careers on shelves like Amazon distribution center. Hell, really hate to call on Broski for the dirty work. I'd rather do it by myself. Crack, crack, crack. My tour route and leave a lazy nigga dizzy. Got more tracks than when the hair salon is busy. Flow for days like that river Mississippi. Freaky nigga like I sing with Pretty Ricky.
Huh? Pretty Ricky shout out, man. Grind on me.
Days like that river, Mississippi, freaky nigga like-
Obviously, the Mississippi River shout out was dope too.
I sing with Pretty Ricky.
Yeah.
Got to add lips from Smiggy nails done, but my trigger finger itchy, clutching on the blicky shit is getting tricky. People love to diss me. I hear every single thing, man. I'm all ears like I took the fan of Disney. Guess that's one way to tell me that you miss me.
Hey man, I've always said this. Haters are really just fans in disguise.
You broke my heart. I had my doubts about you from the start. Push the edge like Vert. On Instagram digging up dirt. You want
push the edge like Vert. All my friends are dead. Push me to the edge. Shouting out Uzi Vert right there.
Push to the edge like Vert. On Instagram digging up dirt. You want to smoke with me first. Well, this one gon'. This one gon' hurt. Down bad boys, sad boys, I've been representing since birth. Yeah, I was down bad about you, but I'm about to have you down worse. I swear you're dead to me, does Mercedes make a hearse? Matter of fact, everybody in this bitch scream out for
you dead to me, does Mercedes make a hearse?
Does Mercedes make a hearse? Matter of fact, everybody in this bitch scream out for my ex. Yeah, for my ex. For my ex.
Hey, we all been there. Fuck my ex. Just don't go literally do it, cause then it gets messy.
For my ex, I can't let it go. For my ex, pay back a bitch. For my ex, this game did the shit. You would have popped up. You would have said shit. You would have posted shit. I know your ass too well.
I mean, it really sounds like we're being taken to church right now. The way that things are hitting, it's soulful and it's rising. Who would have thought we're really just singing "Fuck My Ex," man?
Lying to my face, thought you would've shown a little grace. How can I expect someone who never had their own place to know their damn place? Treat me like I'm dumb or something like it.
How can I expect someone who never had their own place to know their place in this relationship and what's going on? Ooh.
Someone who never
this is bitter and vicious, man.
Had their own place to know their damn place. Treat me like I'm dumb or something like you're running something like they dropped you on your head when you was one or something for my ass.
Oh.
For my ex, right.
Was that Drake doing that? Those ad libs? Right. Yeah, it feels right. Let that piano take us out. It's gotta be. That's the way to do it. Wow. I mean, I tell you what, like, it took to the very end for him to finally start singing and to give us, like, more of a hook. But what I love is that throughout, you just got a cold, calculated Drake who was just spitting, man. Like, he had moments when he was a little bit more vulnerable. He shared some stuff with you because that's just Drake. That's what he does. But in terms of people saying we want Drake back in his rap bag, he gave you that and more on this. And I love that. And even like the last track, which is a little bit more like of a vibe and singing, like he's still firing shots. Like he talked about Kanye, we had Rihanna, we had Joe Budden. We had all kinds of people mentioned on this. I think my favorite track, track one was dope, just the way he came in and just like set the tone. Like this is what you're getting this time around. And then the J. Cole track, obviously, because Cole just kills features. But I love the track that Drake was like, all right, I'm gonna go toe-to-toe with Cole this time. And we're just going to play off of each other and really be on some hip-hop shit. But yeah, overall, man, like I know it's only 6 tracks and just like an addition to the album, but I would love to hear like 12 tracks of this. You know, but this still feels right. Like it feels like get in, hit him quickly, like just kind of improvise in the moment. Like Drake said when he was going in to record this one, like it really feels like, man, this is just like a singular studio session. Like let's get in, let's lay it down. And get out and hit the people with something, man. Just like stream of conscious rap and bring it back to rap and hip hop. Drake, you're Monoxville certified. Hope you guys like today's video. Listen, for some reason here at the end, obviously you enjoy the content. Do me a huge favor, support the channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. Rhythm, it does go a long way. I love you guys. Also, stay tuned. I got a brand new music video just dropped. I'm going to preview it right now.
Illmatic on my tape, but I bet they think it's shady. Just waiting for the day when everybody here will play me. Still dreaming, these fiends, they still scheming. Monday evening feeling like a weekend. Where they sipping brown paper bags, little liquor make it last. Take a taste of that, scraping to get past. They ain't paying cash, where they taking stands. So keep rolling, though the damage can feel hopeless in the land of the broken world. Hey.